Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at adding watermarks to photos using Pixelmator. So the general idea here is you want to upload a photo to the internet and you want to put a little bit of text on the photo, not enough to take away from the photo itself, but just to identify it as a photo you took that's yours. So adding text is easy enough. We'll use the tools here on the left and just take the text tool and we'll just click and I'll just put, say, my name. And then we can make some adjustments to it. We can select it and then stretch it over here so my name's on one line. Now that's not exactly what we want because I don't want it to appear that big on there. I want it to be barely visible. So let's start making some adjustments. First, let's change the font there to something a little bit more normal. Something like that. And then left justify it here. Actually, I'm going to right justify it because I'm going to put it in the bottom right hand corner. Let's leave it up here for now so we can see it a little better. Let's make it a little smaller. That's probably too small. Let's do it somewhere around there. And then we want to start playing with some of the things. Like, for instance, it has some settings on it right now, like it's got a shadow. I'll do Command T here to edit the font. And I see I do have shadows turned on. So now I've got something a little bit better. Now I could make it a different color to have it blend a little bit more with the background. So say something like this. But instead of doing that, I want to keep it black now and I want to make it semi-transparent. So I want to bring up layers here. I'm going to show all the layers using View, Show Layers. And I can see here that the text is, of course, automatically in its own layer there. I can hide it, show it. And blending is set to normal. I'm going to set the opacity down. You can see it fade there. So now it's still black text, but it's fading in with whatever color is there. So that looks pretty good as a watermark, just barely there. I'm going to move it down to the bottom right. And you can see you really can't see it at all now because it's darker there. So what I want to do is I want to change the color and make it white so it lightens the area there. But I can switch the opacity a little bit like that. And now it kind of gives me that watermark effect that I want there. I can put it just where I want in the bottom right hand corner. And now when I export, that'll be there and printed over that. Another type of watermark you may want to add that's a little more extreme is take this here and let's make this huge. And maybe that, not that huge, let's put it like that, right across some critical piece of the display there. And then we'll go ahead and bring up the layers again and we'll make that very dim. So dim, in fact, you can barely see it, but it's still there. That way somebody may be trying to steal the image, may not notice that it's there, and then you could prove later that it's yours. A little more extreme, nothing I would ever do, but it might be something you're looking for. Of course, putting something like that across the entire image may be appropriate in the case where you want to show somebody a sample photo, say you're a photographer and you want to show them, hey, here's the photo I've taken. If you want to purchase it, let me know and I'll give you the original. That way they can't just steal the one that you show them. So I hope you have found this tutorial on watermarks in Pixelmator useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.